Hey class, if you didn't know, I'm Travis Tracy.
And I'm Justin Pittman. And in this movie, we want to explain to you guys some environmental energy issues that are hurting the earth and the organisms on it. We will also discuss solutions that can help the environment, at the same time be beneficial to us and our needs. The issues include the use of non-renewable sources, such as coal, fossil fuels, oil, and natural gases. Here are a few facts how energy is wasted in the U.S.
Love is a burning thing.
Some benefits of renewable resources are listed below. Even though the U.S. isn't where we need to be, we're showing improvement through the years.
Spacious sky for amber waves of gray. Purple mountains.
Now that we've discussed the issues, we will give some solutions that will help solve these problems. Some of the most common ways today are through solar panels and wind turbines.
There are two types of solar panels. Thermal panels, which use the sun's UV rays to heat water instead of gas. The other, photovoltaic panels, which uses the sun's UV rays to turn into electrical energy. As of right now, thermal panels are more efficient than photovoltaic panels in that it takes less thermal panels to heat a commercialized building than it does photovoltaic panels to energize one. Wind turbines can be used in a small setting for battery charging or auxiliary power, or in a larger setting for commercial electrical power. In some states, such as Kansas and Colorado, where there are large plains, wind turbine fields are created, as seen in the picture on the right. Here at Guilford College, we are making these steps in becoming a more environmentally friendly society. Guilford had added 200 solar thermal panels to 9 different buildings on campus, which allows for 9,000 gallons of hot water to be produced every day. This is huge because now Guilford is not having to pay for the gas to produce the hot water and helping the earth at the same time. Besides the thermal panels, Guilford has taken other steps to become a more environmentally friendly society, but with smaller efforts by changing the light switches to automatic switches, installing waterless urinals in almost every bathroom, having energy efficient light bulbs, and growing their own crops for the cafeteria.
Future efforts that should be done to prevent the issues of burning so much fossil fuels, oils, and natural gas would be to provide scientists with more money to spend on figuring out new technology for a more energy-efficient way of life in society today.
Along with that, creating more rebates for residential and commercial building owners to obtain some of the solutions discussed before would help. My uncle is in a solar industry as a distributor and installer in Colorado. Over the past few months, the government has begun to cut back on rebates in Colorado, which is causing more and more people not to want to buy this renewable energy source.
In the future, if America relies fully on the use of energy-efficient resources, then it will help lead to solving other concerns in the world, such as ozone depletion, global warming, and toxic waste. Alright y'all, that pretty much wraps up our movie. Just want to thank you for watching it. We love you, Megan.